Hello everyone, welcome to Tesca Technologies Private Limited. Myself Arvind Paliwal and I am here to explain about 3-phase synchronous machine. 3-phase synchronous machine which we are using here has order code 69009. Start with introduction. The word synchronous is originated from Greek. The prefix syn means with and chronos means time. A synchronous motor literally operates in time with or in synchronization with the power system. Due to the fact the synchronization motor are fitted with special operating characteristics, industries are more and more using such motor. Included in the main reason for the industries to specify synchronous motor to drive a wide range of applications are the high efficiency and the fact that they are sustainable to operate as synchronous compensating machines for power supply factor correction. So we have many power ratings available like 350 watts, 750 watt, 1 kilowatt, 2 kilowatt, 3 kilowatt and 5 kilowatt. Voltage inputs are also available, 440 volt AC 50 hertz and additionally 110 volt DC for rotor. RPMs 440 or 2880 RPM. So some technical descriptions of synchronous motor. The mainframe yoke of this machine is made up of high permeability rolled steel. Rotor and stator core are built up of low loss silicon steel lamination. Slip rings are molded from brass rings. Enabled copper conductors are used in armature winding. Stator and armature winding are impregnated with high dielectric strength thermostatic varnish and are cured to render them immune from moisture and acid alkalis and oils. We are using this setup to run this synchronous machine at synchronous speed. This setup has a variac, a DC supply to provide DC to field of this motor, and multifunction meter to measure current and voltage, a 3-phase power supply block to supply 3-phase to this motor. So firstly we will connect the 3-phase power supply block R phase to multifunction meters R phase, then Y phase of 3-phase power block to Y phase of multifunction meter, and now B phase of 3-phase power supply block to multifunction meters B phase. Now we'll connect neutral of 3-phase power supply block to multifunction meters neutral. Now we will take R phase from the multifunction meter and connect it on the R terminal of synchronous motor. Now we will connect the Y phase of synchronous motor with the Y phase of multifunction meter. Now B phase of synchronous motor to the multifunction meter's B phase. Now we'll connect variac input to the input AC of DC supply block, and then second point to the input AC. And now we'll take the first output of DC and connect it on F terminal, field terminal of synchronous motor, and then second to second field terminal of synchronous motor. Now we will switch on the multifunction meter's power supply, then we will switch on the MCB of 3-phase power block, and here you can see it's showing voltage between line to line, line to neutral and current. Now we will switch on the AC power supply block and you can measure the line to line current between three lines of the phase and line to neutral between 3-phase lines and neutral, and now current measurements. Now as you can see, we have set this to ampere current reading. Now we will switch on the 3-phase power supply block, and as the motor starts rotating, we will switch on the variac and provide DC excitation up to 50 to 70 volts to this motor to achieve the synchronous speed. Now at a specific excitation, we will reach a stage where rotor get interlocked with the rotating magnetic field and we will achieve the synchronous speed. So with this, we end our explanation of three-phase synchronous machine. If you have any queries, you can contact Tesca Technologies Private Limited. Thank you for watching. If you like the video, please like, share and subscribe.